Hello friends, today let us learn the fifth unit of strength of materials, which is theory of simple bending. Here we are going to solve problems related to bending. You know, suppose we have a beam like this. Say this is the bottom plank of a desk on which most of the colleges we use desks where the students will sit. There will be two legs here, supports here. So this will be a number of students will be sitting here, 5-6 students will be sitting. So this can be called as a simply supported beam. Now this beam, when the students sit here on this, it will be like a UDL. This is the span of the beam. This is like a UDL. And this section of this will be like this rectangular section. Now this will be like a beam, and this is going to bend like this. This is going to bend like this. Now this is subjected to bending. Now any problem on this type of this thing, or beams which we come across in buildings, structures, we have to use this theory of simple bending. In this theory of simple bending, we use a equation known as the general bending equation, which can be derived, but you do not have the derivation of that. If you know it, that is sufficient. This equation is called as the general bending equation. General bending equation. The equation is like this. M by I is equal to F by Y is equal to E by R. This equation we call as the general bending equation. There is a mathematical proof for this equation, but we don't have need to prove that. This we should know this equation, and we should be able to apply it in a problem where some quantities are given, some quantities are asked. We have to apply this and solve those problems. Now this equation is known as the general bending equation. In this equation, M is the maximum bending moment. Maximum bending moment on the beam in Newton millimeter. Now this sometimes may not be directly given. If it is not directly given, it will be given indirectly, or you may have to find out. To know this maximum bending moment, we should know what is the nature of beam, that is whether it is cantilever, whether it is a simply supported beam, and whether it is loaded with a uniformly distributed load or point load, whatever it is. So, and what is its span, what is the length of the beam, all these details if we know, then we can find this bending moment. Right. Now, I is the moment of inertia of the beam section in millimeter to the power of 4. Now, generally the section of the beam will be either it can be rectangular or it may be circular. Now the bending moment is taken about the horizontal axis passing through the center of gravity. This is called the width, this is called the depth. Then you know that the bending the moment of inertia will be BD cube by 12. If it is circular, it will be pi d to the power of 4 by 64. Pi d to the power of 4 by 64. will give you the this thing, bending moment of inertia of the circular section. Generally what we get is this. In for this case, it will be BD cube by 12. B stands for the width of the beam, D stands for the depth of the beam. So if we know B and D, we can get the moment of inertia. F is bending stress, allowable bending stress, or it can also be a tensile stress. Generally it is tensile stress of the beam material, in Newton per mm square or megapascals. Y is distance of outermost fiber, from neutral axis, in millimeter. In the case of this, see, when a beam is subjected to bending, the axis passing through its center of gravity is called as the neutral axis. The horizontal axis passing through its center of gravity is known as the neutral axis. Why it is called as neutral axis is the stress at this point will be zero, and the upper half of the beam, that is the beam above this, is subjected to compression. The lower half is generally subjected to tension. So this distance from the neutral axis to the outermost fiber, if it is a uniform section, Y will be D by 2. If it is a rectangular section or this thing, D by 2 will give you the distance of the outermost fiber from the neutral axis. E is modulus of elasticity or Young's modulus of the material of the beam in Newton per mm square. And R is radius of curvature, of the beam. That is, when the beam bends like this, it becomes a part of the, part of a circle. What is its radius? That radius is called as radius of curvature in mm. So these are the units, and these stand, what is what? Sometimes they will ask you in the theory, write the bending equation, general bending equation, and give the nomenclature, that is, what is M, what is I, what is this, and what are their units, they will ask like this. Now, in this equation, which part we have to use? See, we can use either M by I is equal to F by Y. This much only we can use. Depends upon what is given and what is asked. We can use even this F by Y is equal to E by R. These two can also be used depending upon what is given and what is asked. We can use these two, or we can use these two depending upon what is the given data and what is to be calculated depending upon that. Now, this equation is called as the general bending equations. Now, next, what they will ask is, what are the assumptions that we make in the proof of this equation? To prove this equation mathematically, I told you already that we can prove it mathematically. In the proof, we make some assumptions, like the section of the beam is homogeneous throughout the section. That is, wherever you take, any section, the entire section will be of the same material, having the same properties. It will not differ from one place to another place. So that is called as homogeneous. The upper part is in compression, the lower part is in tension. Like this, we make some assumptions. These assumptions, it is subjected to only bending, no other type of this thing, no other stress other than the bending stress it is subjected to. All these assumptions we make. Only when we make these assumptions, we can prove this equation. So they will ask, what are the assumptions made in general bending, proof of general bending equation? That you must be able to do. Next, you should also know, see, when we take up m by I is equal to f by y. M by I is equal to f by y. Then m will be equal to f into I by y. This I will go here, I by y. This I by y is also called as the section modulus. It is denoted by z. Z is called section modulus. Section modulus in mm cube, because I will be in, this is mathematically I by y, I will be in mm to the power of 4 and y will be in mm, so 1 mm 1 mm will cancel. The unit of z is mm cube. Now for generally the problem that is asked is on a rectangle, beam of rectangular section. If it is rectangular section, I will be BD cube by 12 and y will be d by 2. So these 2 ones are 2, 2 6 are 12. 1d here gets cancelled. So z will be equal to bd square by 6. This is z. So in case we want, we can use it this way also. M is equal to f into z. Now to calculate m, next to calculate m, we get different cases. The cases that we get are like this. First case is the beam may be a cantilever beam subjected to a point load. Subjected to a point load. It may be a cantilever beam. The first case for calculating bending moment, you get different for calculating bending moment. We get different cases. The first case that you get is cantilever beam with beam loaded with a point load at free end. So that means this is the cantilever beam. It is supported here. This is its free end. It carries a point load at the free end. So this load will be given maybe in kilonewton or whatever it is, kilonewton or newton. This will be generally given, L will be given in meters. This will be in meters. Now that W, what is the maximum bending moment? Maximum bending moment will be at this point and it will be W into L. Maximum bending moment M will be equal to W, that is the point load in newton, multiplied by L in meters. Generally it is given in meters. Now we want bending moment in newton millimeter. So this multiplied by 1000 will give you the bending moment in newton mm. If W is point load in newton and L is span or length of beam, in meters. If you substitute this, 1000 will convert that meter into millimeter. Generally it is, span is generally, or length of the beam is generally given in meters, so we will put that 1000 there. Second, cantilever beam, with UDL, uniformly distributed load throughout the span, that means here, here you have a cantilever beam, then they give its length, this is UDL, it is throughout the span, this is again L in meters, this so many, this is small w, so many newton per meter length. This unit, it will be given in newton per meter. or if it is given in kilonewton meter, you have to convert it into newton per meter by multiplying it by 1000. Now in this case, m will be equal to small w, that is the UDL per meter in newton per meter, into L square divided by 2 into 1000. L should be in meter, newton millimeter. Here also L should be in meter. This 1000 will convert one length into millimeter, and the other length will be in meter only. Newton per meter into meter, that will get cancelled, so it will become in newton. So this is the second case. The third case is these two together, that is, if you may have this thing, it may be this cantilever beam of beam, this thing, it has both this thing, a point load at the free end and also a UDL throughout the span. Then m will be equal to, this is cantilever beam, cantilever beam with point load at free end and UDL, and UDL throughout span, throughout span. This way also it can be given. Then maximum bending moment will be this plus this, that is W into capital W into L plus small w into L square by 2, this whole thing multiplied by 1000. So many newton mm, that 1000 will be taken outside as common factor. W into L divided plus WL square by 2, whole thing multiplied by 1000, so many newton millimeter. So these are the three cases if it is cantilever. Then it may be a simply supported beam also. If it is a simply supported beam, again you get three cases in simply supported beam also. That is, one, number one, a simply supported beam with a point load at the mid span. First case is simply supported beam with point load at mid span. So they will give a simply supported beam, simply supported beam, its length will be given. They will say it is carrying a point load W at the mid span. That is, this is L by 2, it is exactly in the center, this is also L by 2. Now this will be W by 2, this also will be W by 2, this is W newtons, W by 2 newton, W by 2 newton, this is L by 2, maximum bending moment will be here, and that bending moment, maximum bending moment will be W into L divided by 4, that is W by 2 into L by 2. Either way, either from that side or from this side, it will be W L by 4 into 1000, that is to convert this into millimeter, so many newton millimeter. Then it may be a simply supported beam with UDL throughout the span. Simply supported beam. Second case, simply supported beam with UDL, uniformly distributed load, throughout the span, throughout span. That means it will be loaded like this. This is the beam, it is simply supported. Now the length is L meters, it carries a load of UDL of throughout span, small w, newton per meter. Now m will be equal to W L square, small w L square by 8 into 1000 newton mm. Now it may be a combination of these two cases, that is the third case In the third case, you may have a simply supported beam carrying UDL throughout span and point load at mid span. In that case, the maximum bending moment on the beam will be the total of these two, that is WL by 4 plus small WL square by 8, whole thing multiplied by 1000, so many Newton millimeter. So these formulae you must remember. There will be 6 cases, totally there will be 6 cases. In case you have to find out the bending moment, this is how you have to find out, depending upon which case is given. This you, I hope you have understood this. We'll take up the problems on this, numericals now. After this, I'll take up the numericals on this.